Cool Runnings, the story of four guys who, against the odds, achieved something that no one ever believed they could. The story of the underdog. It didn't win an Oscar, but it affected me in a way that no other film ever has since. I remember walking out of the cinema and thinking, one day, I want to make someone feel something like that. So, who is this guy? Well, my name is Liam and I've loved films all my life, but I wasn't satisfied with just watching them.
No, I wanted to make stories.
My own stories, with the action, the locations, the journeys. Were they any good? No, they sucked. But I loved dreaming them up anyway. From paintings in kindergarten to travel blogs on my gap year, I became obsessed with the adventure. Storytelling was my thing, and if I could, I'd do it forever. But when it did come time to pick a career, I was at a crossroad. Because as much as I love filmmaking, film was a scary mountain to climb for me. I had no connections, no equipment, no content, no contacts, and no clue. It was a long shot, it was a dream. And on the other hand, I could just go to uni, do a psychology degree, get a stable job, do something that I wasn't in love with, but that was interesting and achievable and safe. And on that day, the mountain was a little too tall for me, and I took the easy road. I studied psychology for 1 year, writing essays and conducting experiments during the day. But at night, I found myself watching films again, every night, and not just watching them now, but analysing them. The character arcs, the structure, the perspective, the big questions.
If you could see your whole life from start to finish, would you change things?
Nobody wants to look back on their life one day and regret something, especially when they still have the power to change it. It wasn't that I wasn't interested in psychology. The concepts really interested me, just not the science. Things like memories, motivation, dreams, attention, decision-making, they became the basis for new ideas I was having. Stories that were original and different. Stories that could make someone feel something. And all of a sudden, there I was again, in front of that big decision. But this time I knew where the other path led, and I didn't want to play it safe anymore. It was time to stop looking at that mountain, and it was time to start climbing it. So, I got to work. I had 1 year,
more like 10 months,
to make as much as I possibly could. I made miniseries, my own short films. I started a YouTube channel. I brainstormed. I learned how to edit. I brainstormed some more. My ideas growing, shaping, developing. I read scripts. I read books on writing scripts. I tried to learn as much about story as I possibly could. And I realized that this was it.
This is a pretty picture.
Scene 20.
Take 5.
Action. All of that work hadn't been any work at all, because this was what I wanted to do and who I wanted to be. In many ways, I feel like those four Jamaican guys in the bathtub. I am the underdog. I still don't have the connections or the equipment, and I haven't been doing this for too long. But I know that this is the right road for me now, and I'm willing to work harder than ever to make sure that this dream turns into a reality. And besides, everyone loves an underdog.